Welcome to Lucen Talks. Today we are talking about tiny houses. Can you please tell us about yourself and your community?
So I work for River Ridge Escape Tiny Homes, and there we're a dealer for four different builders of the tiny homes. And now we've kind of expanded out to growing tiny home communities for people to live in or have part-time places there. But I do the sales and marketing, and Ed Waters is our owner and developer. So he started back in 2015, kind of got a whole River Ridge Escape going. And it's actually funny because he was going to start it out as a luxury mobile home company. And then he just realized the integrity of the buildings just wasn't there. So he switched over to luxury tiny homes, and it just really has taken off a lot, especially last year with the TV shows kind of broadcasting it. And so that's kind of who we are.
How much do tiny houses cost, and can you build a tiny house anywhere?
Our tiny homes range between $40,000 and $96,000. Basically, that's based off of the floor plan, the materials used, and which floor plan you do, like ones without the loft are, of course, cheaper. And then delivery cost is included in the price when we do everything together. And then you can build them anywhere. So, for instance, there's a builder in Atlanta. They build them there, but you can't put the tiny homes in Atlanta yet because of the zoning. County and city regulations are a lot different per city, state, and just kind of. It really depends on that for where you can actually put them, but building them, you can basically do it anywhere.
Are tiny houses sturdy and safe? Can families live in tiny houses?
Oh, yeah. Me and my husband actually live in a tiny home, so we can vouch for it. And we've got another one on the way, so we'll be a little family in a tiny home. So it really depends on how you brace it down to the ground, if they're sturdy. If you're moving them down the road, you want to make sure you have a good trailer frame and the structure is sturdy and a lot of things. You just want to make sure you're doing it right if you are going to build your own. On the other hand, if you're going to be in a permanent foundation, we like to cross brace it and tie it down to the ground. You can use hurricane straps or just those cross bracing techniques to just keep it sturdy. And if there's any winds coming through, the house isn't going to be going down the mountain or, you know, end up somewhere you don't want it to be. So they're pretty sturdy, but that's really dependent on how you set it up on the lot. Me and my husband live in one. We've lived in one for about a year and a half now. And then we have a few neighbors in our little tiny home community, Little River Escape. So we've got one where it's a couple and they've got three kids in their tiny home. And it's only 400 square feet. And a lot of people are like, oh my gosh, heck no, I'd kill somebody if that was the case. But it's really perspective. And if you can do it, you can do it. But you got to really be mentally set to live in that kind of space and know that there's not a whole lot of privacy when you have all your family in 400 square feet. So it's really a perspective thing. But yes, families can definitely live in them. Thank you.